There is a funny term that is very familiar to everyone down here when it comes to math. What is math? Math is exactly an abbreviation for mental abuse to humans. And it seems like that math has always been one of the most scariest things that have ever existed on Earth. So before diving into my speech, I would like to extend my question for you, the audience. By raising your hand, how many of you guys sitting down here have ever admitted that you and math would never belong with each other, forever? Wow. The vast majority. So I've been wondering for many consecutive years that, is it true that math is a nightmare that we never be able to learn it? And after so many years living with it, every day, spending hours and hours solving math problems, I think the answer is no. In fact, there's always been a prejudice that we need to have such a thing called math brain, or the innate ability when we were born if you want to be excellent at math. It is completely tremendous, dangerous mythology that everyone believes in it, which had caused people to always have a fear of math. It is completely contradicted to what we have witnessed in our lives. Just consider this case. Why are all of you good at playing games? Is it because you were born with the ability to master playing games? Obviously no, right? Because when you play games, you played it with the comfortable state of mind. You played it for as a way for you to relax. So why don't we just try to apply those comfortable state of mind, those as a way for us to relax into learning math? Then there will be a different whole story. Because for me, all of you down here is a genius at math. And you guys probably don't believe it. Especially it is spoken from a guy who come from a math class of 2024. But believe me, it is true. Moving on. Math is just not a subject. It is a masterpiece of explaining everything to be simple. I used to ask myself that, why do students usually get confused when it comes to math? Or even adults, they can usually what the definitions of a term mean. And I finally found out that it is because of the polysemous natures of mathematical term, the abstract of the definitions, or maybe just the math signs that truly frighten people. Let me show you this thing. The leg of an isosceles triangle? What does the leg mean? The leg is a part of your body which helps you to. So does an isosceles triangle be able to? No, right? The leg of an isosceles triangle is just basically the two adjacent equal signs of a triangle. Two equal signs, size. And what about this word? Abscissa. When I first saw this word, I thought this is a really complicated word with a very complicated meanings. But when I search, it is very simple. It is just the X coordination. It means that, for example, you have the point P, A and B. Then the A stands for the abscissa. So it is clear that we can all redefine those complicated words, those polysemous natures of mathematical term, into a much more simple way that we can easily understand it, because American mathematicians, Stan Gerder, who comes from the University of Denver, also agrees with me. He says that the essence of mathematics is not to make simple things too complicated, but to make complicated things too simple. Let me show you this example by showing you a definition of a knowledge that may be a high school student or even a university graduate may get confused of. A definition of limit. Whoa! What is this? I suddenly swear that for the first time I started learning calculus in high school. This incomprehensible definitions almost crippled me. And this pile of demands took me more than one semester to understand it. But luckily now I'm understanding it. So after fully capable of comprehending what this definitions entails, I think I can redefine this into a much more simple way that even a third grade student can understand it. Okay, listen carefully. All you need to know is that in mathematics, limits is a thing that you can never reach of. For example, 0.999999 is very close to 1, but it's not equal to 1. So just close your eyes and imagine you have that we have a group of friends walking towards the heaven. And please bear in mind that we will never be able to reach the heaven. But we will get closer and closer with many steps taken. It means that the more steps you take, the closer you are to the heaven. Seems ridiculous, right? So therefore, we have a thing. It's that the limits of something that related to steps. In mathematics, we call functions of steps. When steps come to infinity, equal to heaven, is that we come really, really close to heaven. Or just take another example. Imagine that we have a cake, and our task is to divide the cake and then give it to someone else. Divide it in half. So, start the first process, divide the cake into half, and give it to others. And it is clear that after repeat that process for 10 times, 20 times, your cake will become super, super small. But what about we repeat that process in 100 times, 1,000 times, or infinity times? Our cake will become super, super, super tiny that even our naked eyes are unable to see it, seemingly invisible. But it is still there. Your cake is still there. It's just too small for you to see it. Therefore, we have the limits of 1 over 2 to the exponents of cuts when cuts come to infinity equal to 0. Zero here stands for the disappearance of your cake. But it not disappear. It seemingly disappear. Okay, so it is clear that we can all redefine complex and abstract concepts into a much more simple way that we can see it and we can commonly encounter it in our daily lives. And there's also a reason, another reason, that I say everyone here is a genius at math. Because math is magical. It appears in every aspect of our lives. It is just you unintentionally overlook or just fail to recognize it. What I mean by this is that your qualities that demonstrate your genius in mathematics have manifested themselves through numerous events in your life. It is just you haven't realized them. I bet that you used to see these situations in your real life. Is that if you lost a thing and your task is to find it as fast as possible. So it is clear that we don't panic or hastily search for every corner, for every knock in our house. Instead, we will sit back, contemplate, and asking ourselves, whoa, where did the last time I saw my item?
And after I saw my item, where did I go next? So obviously, after posing those questions, you will come to those locations first, and that locations, your brain will gradually recall the subsequent event. And eventually, you truly remember where the item was. So in mathematics, we call it as a tracing back method. Is that we come from a result, we trace back to find a clue for our solution. So when you are unable to solve a math problem, it is still okay. Just read the solutions, it is great. But promise with me, read it from the bottom to the top. Because most of the math problems, they use the results as a clue for the solutions. So it is easier for you to understand what they write in the solutions, just read it from the bottom to the top. Okay, it's all about learning math now. For me, math is just not about learning. It is about opening for us opportunities. For those who are unfamiliar with me, let me tell you my story. When I was in primary school, I used to be a serious gaming addict. I failed my second year exam to a specialized school just because the date before the test was taken, I was playing game. Instead, I could sit back and revise for the exam or just simply get some sleep. But no, I chose to play games until midnight. And obviously, I failed. However, when I first introduced to math, it changed my life completely. When I first introduced to math in the simplest way possible, given motivation for me to learn it, I saw that I have more things to do with math rather than sit down and play games. I see that this intriguing thing that God has ever created truly captivates me. And I think my experience of learning math is very similar to all of you guys here. Because at first, my perceptions of learning math, it just revolve around remembering facts mechanically, trying to decipher the math equations just to tackle the intangible problems that held no personal significance, that helped me nothing in my life. But day by day, I started to realize that math possessed a tremendous practicality, an inherent allure that's really helped me. It encompassed me more than the uncovering solutions. It involves acquiring the skills to pose the pertinent inquiries. Math is just not about numbers. It's just not about the equations. But it teaches you how to be innovative in creating solutions to a real life example. So when I trying to solve a math problems, hours and hours, day and days, months and months, it doesn't mean that I'm stubborn to only one math problem, but it teaches me how to be persistent, how to be persevere whenever I face difficulty. Therefore, when people say that they can learn math, I think it is more to do with beliefs rather than talent or ability. It is just an illusion because we all know that it is completely clear that math appears in every aspect of our lives. And you have successfully solved it for many times. So your math genius is just about time to be awakened. And obviously, I'm not standing here for criticize you for having the fears of math. I'm standing here with a purpose and hope that you will change your answer towards the questions I asked you at the beginning of my talk, and we together grow better, and we will change my mind open our heart in the ways of learning math. Thank you very much, and my name is Truong.